What if I told you that you can now have access to the best AI video models in the world all in one place? I'm talking of Kling 1.6, Minimax, Vidu, WAN 2.1, the brand new Veo2, and even the just released Kling 2.0, all happening inside OpenArt's brand new video generator. Let me show you how to use it to create mind-blowing content in just minutes. OpenArt AI recently released a game-changing video creation platform. At the core of it is their video page, where you get 4 different modes of generating videos depending on your creative needs. Number one is text to video. Just type what you imagine and it generates a full video from scratch. Then we have image to video. Just upload an image and it brings it to life. Then we have element to video. Combine multiple image reference into just a single animated video. And finally, we have audio, where you can add background music and sounds to your video clip to bring it to life. Each one of these is packed with new features and functionalities that will help you produce stunning content. Let's walk through them step by step by starting with text to video feature. Now, under models here, we can see the drop down arrow with all the models that OpenArt AI has. They have Kling 1.6, Pixverse, Vidu, Hello, WAN 2.1, and the newly added Veo2 from Google, and they just released the Kling 2.0. Kling 1.6 is fantastic for video fidelity, but if you are after more dynamic cinematic results, then Veo2 and Kling 2.0 are your go-to models. These upgrades offer more stability, realism, and better camera movement. I'll show you the results as we proceed. Now, here's how the text to video feature works. First, input a detailed prompt. As you're inputting your prompt, here are just 5 things that you must keep in mind to get the best results out of this feature. Ensure that your prompt has got the main subject character or focus in the scene, the action, what the subject is doing, the environment, the background or setting of the scene, the lighting, the type of light, natural, dim or neon, and the camera movement, how the camera moves, like zooming in or panning to direct the viewers focus and enhance the story depending with what you are creating. I input my prompt in the text bar. Here my prompt says, a woman in a white dress walking through a sunlight forest. I have a subject, a woman in a white dress, and I have the action that the woman is doing, walking through the sunlight forest, and this is the environment with soft rays filtering through the trees. This is also part of the sunlight. The camera tracks her as she walks. And this is the camera movement, capturing the serene environment and her graceful movement. So the prompt contains all the best 5 elements that makes it pop. Then when we scroll down a little bit, we have this auto enhancer. When you turn this feature on, it will automatically add more details to your prompt and generate a richer result. So you can try between on and off which one generates the best results for you. And when we scroll down here, we have the creative level. This slider lets you adjust how creative your AI interprets your prompt. You can crank it up for something more experimental or leave it lower for something more precise. I love leaving it at 0.5. It usually generates the best results for me. And we have the duration. Not all models give you this option for duration. If we come to models and select Kling 2.0, it will not give you the option for duration. It is set to 5 seconds by default, and it will not give you the option to specify the aspect ratio, but it will have these 3 options you can choose from. So I thought of mentioning that. You can select 10 seconds or 5 seconds depending with what you're creating. And on the quality mode, I love selecting Pro for that high better quality. And from there, you can add the negative prompts. I'll make it simple by adding blurry, low quality, and distorted. From there, when we scroll up a little bit, we've got the auto sound and the auto speech mode. These 2 new toggles allows OpenArt to generate background sounds, ambient noise, and even speech to match your video. It's incredibly intuitive, though at the time of recording this video, OpenArt has not yet brought in a feature where we can upload our own voiceover or our own audio sound to the video. Once all the settings are made, we click generate to generate the results. I will use all the features and show you which one generated the best results. So this is Kling 1.6. I love how the camera follows the person and the lighting in the background and how the body moves. Then we have Pixverse AI. I love the lighting, the camera movement, and the body movement, which is just so cinematic. Then we have Vidu. I love how the camera follows the person and how it goes through the trees and gives it that cinematic look, except for the distortion and the blurry in the subject and having like missing a couple of frames in the video. Then we have Hello. It's quite cinematic. I love how the subject moves and how the camera angle follows the person, except the background is like shaking, which is something that we usually get most of the times when we are generating videos using AI. Then we've got WAN 2.0, which just like generated something that I didn't request. I love the lighting and the overall background, except for a subject is like still not moving to either direction. Then we have Veo2. I love the overall background and the blurriness and how the camera moves slowly. This is just so perfect. Then we have Kling 2.0. I love how the camera follows the person. It gives that cinematic look and how it pauses as it reaches near the subject. There is just that age, that rush to the subject and trying to introduce what is happening in the scene. Now, let's talk about one of the coolest features in this update, which is imaged video. This is a game changer if you're someone who loves working with visuals but doesn't want to deal with all the hassle of video editing. With this update, you can upload an image, whether it's a photo or a graphic, and transform it into a full motion video. Simply upload an image from your library or even use an image you've created through OpenArt. When you click on the option button, you can upload your image, or you can select from the ones you've already generated in OpenArt AI, or you can select from your characters. So I'll click on history and select an image that I created within OpenArt AI using the same prompt that we had used earlier in text to image. Now, when we observe carefully, we've got the start frame and we have the end frame. You can set the start frame and the end frame to define how the video begins and ends. This is especially handy for smooth transitions or creating a specific narrative flow. You can also add camera movements like a slow motion, but we'll come back to this later. One thing you must take note of is not all models have got this feature. When we come to Kling and when we select Hello, we find out that it does not have the start frame and the end frame feature. So go back to Kling, and when we scroll down here, we need to paste in a prompt that describes the action unfolding in this scene. Make it as detailed as possible, but try to make it as simple as possible. Then from there, when we scroll down, we leave the clarity level to 0.5 and the duration to 5 and the quality mode to Pro. And we also repeat the same negative prompts that we had used in the text to video feature and click on create. I love the overall quality that you get from image to video. So this is Kling 1.6. I love how the lighting goes through the subject, though there is no much camera movement to it. Then we have Pixverse, which has got that cinematic slow motion to it, the lighting, the hair movement, and the subject. It's just so perfect. Then we've got the Hello standard. There's a little bit of noise on the subject and the body movement, the legs, a bit off to what we would expect, but this is something that we usually get with these AI tools. Then we've got WAN 2.1, which kind of like has a lot of noise, something that I did not expect to have. Then we've got Veo2, kind of like cinematic, and that 10 is just so amazing. Look at the lighting, the posture, the hair movement. It's just so perfect. Then we've got Kling 2.1. It also has that cinematic look. The hair movement is just so perfect, though there is a bit of the camera movement, but this is just so amazing from the results that we've gotten so far. Now, let's talk about the start and the end frame. As I mentioned earlier, this feature is only available in Kling 1.6, Pixverse, and in Vidu. What you want to do is, first of all, upload a frame that will act as your start frame and a second frame that will act as your end frame. We use this sun image that we have as a start frame. We'll come to history and we'll pick this image as our end frame, which has got the backside. From there, we can also add some auto sounds. Since it's a forest, we can have sounds for birds, trees, and air. Now, one thing that I must mention is that the duration is set to default as 5 seconds with the start and the end frame, and the quality mode is set to Pro. Hopefully, in the near future, we can have up to 10 seconds.
millions of video generation with this feature.
So this is the generated clip. When it comes to having human characters, it kind of adds a jump cut in between the transitions, where I think there has to be that smooth transition from the start frame to the end frame. However, I love the starting point and how the ending point is, which is kind of something that we can work with, and kind of like cinematic and that movie transition, something cool in my opinion. Now let's dive into element tab. This one is perfect for creators who want to mix and match different visual elements to create unique videos. Let's say you have a character but you want to add different accessories or change their clothing. You can do all that right in here. We'll select our character, and here we're going to add a specific clothing for our character. I'll select a black dress. Just generated this dress here in OpenArt AI. You can add up to 4 elements, but I'll leave it to 2 and provide a description of the action. I would say a woman in a black dress walking through the sunlight city, then leave the duration to 5 seconds and the quality mode to pro. And from there, I add negative prompts and click on create. This is super helpful if you are creating custom avatars or characters for your videos and need specific clothing props. And just like that, your character will change their outfit and put on the specific outfit that you've provided. That this is a very cool feature, a very wonderful feature. And now let's talk about one of the most useful update, audio. Here what you want to do is drag and drop a video file that you want to add audio to. From there, you can describe some sound in the background. That's if you want to add some. If your video already has some sound in the background, you can toggle on the keep original sound. Here you can import the text you would like your character to say. It can be in English or in Chinese. Other languages are not being supported at the moment of recording this video. And you can turn on the auto lip sync. And we are limited to only 68 characters at the time of recording this video, which I hope to see increase as time goes by. Then here we can select a character we would love to use for our audio.
Ready to create something fresh? Just OpenArt delivers high quality visuals and videos. Your story deserves to be felt. Let OpenArt turn your feelings into visual poetry.
And at the bottom, we can adjust the speed of our audio. Select this same video file. We turn on the auto sound and scroll down a little bit. We turn on speech. Paste in what you want your character to say. Select your character and click create.
I love walking in the rain.
I love the lip sync and how natural the mouth movement,
I love
the hair movement and the body language are together. Except there are a little bit of some distortions here and there, but the lip sync, the movement, it's so natural, which is just so clean. Now here are some quick tips for using these new features effectively. Always create clear descriptive prompts. Be specific about the environment, the lighting, and action in your scene to get the best results. Use the negative feature prompts if you want to avoid common issues like blurriness or poor resolution. Experiment with the creativity level. If you're looking for a more abstract look, increase the creativity. For more realistic results, dial it down a little bit. So these are the major updates on OpenArt AI. You'll find the link to OpenArt in the description below. Thank you OpenArt AI for sponsoring this video. Make sure you subscribe to our channel because there are more huge updates coming on OpenArt AI and other AI tools. From here, God bless you. See you in the next video.